My name is Bane Lelukele, and I am in education. Basically, I try to make learning fun and experiential. So I link content to the students' interests, and then I help them also with examination skills and how to thrive in test conditions, because not all of us are good at that. The approach that I've developed has been developed over 3 years, and it looks at how you take what the student knows and then unpack to the unknown. And usually with traditional tutoring, they follow what's in the textbook. I rarely use a textbook, and generally my students only figure out at the end of the lesson what content it was that we were working on. So it's more for them to discover things along the way, and then I kind of just tell them what the subject name for that thing is, more than to teach them. And we also do very little sit down type of things. It's very much experience. We're outdoors, we're traveling, we're watching movies to learn, as opposed to what traditional tutors do, where it's similar to school. I'm feisty. Hey, I think any teachers that have come across me can agree that, you know, when I put a full stop, I'm very clear about the fact that it's not a question mark, it's not a comma, it's a full stop. This is how you deal with my students. I don't care how you deal with other students. These are the rules I'm setting for my students to thrive, and I will definitely follow up. I go to parents' meetings, I set up consultations with teachers, I evaluate tests and exams. So as soon as they've written, I want to see it, just to see that really you're being fair to the student. And I think that even though that took time, it's one of my strengths, in the sense that in my mind, the worst thing that I can lose is my students' confidence. And so that almost feels like it's the only thing I can lose. Otherwise, I have nothing else to lose. So when you have nothing to lose, you're willing to risk everything. My why, and this is probably what makes my company somewhat of a difficult company to run, but when I was at school, I was very much the no-no child. I had a teacher who almost every day told me I was gonna be nothing in life. And it was only after I left school where I was like, wait, I wasn't the problem. Actually, she was the problem. And so I made a deal with myself that I'd never allow another child to have to go through that, where for almost 6 years or 5 years of your schooling, you think that you are the problem. So that's why that's also something that's different about our approach, is that it's very holistic. So we also do life orientation. Students also ask me personal questions. We engage in that sense. We try to become a part of the family also. Parents trust us quite a lot. So it's more than the subject. It's about, can this child become the best version of themselves while still getting through the system that has been designed for them? If not today, when? I think I've delayed a lot of things in my life for various reasons, for personal relationships, romantic relationships, family, for other people's confidence. You know, especially in university, you have that dilemma of the lecturer wanting to be the knower of all. And I've held myself back, but now I'm just like, if not now, when? I can't be waiting for someone higher than me in the hierarchy of life to do it. So I just go for it. And also, what if I die tomorrow and I've like never done it, or at least said it to somebody? And I think that's always one of my things. I either write it down, I email it to myself, or I say it to someone. Because once you've said it to somebody, you can be held accountable. Everybody's got something. It's not you, it's them. That is probably, I've always been somewhat of a people pleaser. I think also having come from a very religious home where submission of a child is a very, very important thing. And that saying of a child must be seen, not heard, was very big in my household. And yeah, I think a younger me, I would have to say, you know, people instructed you to do things because that's what they knew. It was more about them than you. So like, just live your life and have fun. That's what I would tell a younger me.